We're the Ghostbusters. We're clever, courageous, and strong.
Hello, we're back again with Bill, the Ecto-1 from Ghostbusters. We are still in issue 19. I think we're going to actually finish issue 19 for now. Let me quickly run through what we have. Well, stage 67 we already did. That was the roof lights for the Ecto-1. What did they call? Ecto-mobile. Oh, okay, never heard of that phrase before. So that's 67. We've done this. In stage 68, we're going to install the body front, or not install, we're going to construct the body front frame, which is only these steps, which is very simple. In stage 69, we're doing the headlight LEDs, body and frame parts, which is the main body for the car. These are the headlight system for the car. We're not going to connect those two together, so I have no clue why we should be working on this thing and that thing when those two are not actually connected together. And we are working on the kick frame, door catch, and rear frame in the final stage, stage 70. Not quite sure we're going to take care of that. What we are going to do, however, is we are actually going to start with the front section, the headlights. Let me get the headlights over right now. So here we have our beautiful little Japanese spaghetti with all these cables running coming through it from it. I'll explain the most of this cable later. The LED headlights, which are going over here, aren't even inserted in yet. Those are these white LEDs we have over here. And let's see if they actually are connected to the power mod. Let me check. I think they are. Let's push the button. I think it's this button. Yes, here we are. These aren't going to go. Let me put them in right now, actually, and you can see what I mean. I'm not going to push them in all the way through. But here we have the front headlights. And as you can see, these are cool white LEDs, which is wrong. This car is a 1959 Cadillac, and I don't think that car had halogen lights. So we're going to change these lights into warm LEDs, which I have over here, a bag of warm LEDs. So what I'm going to do first, I'm going to cut off the white LEDs from this cable and exchange them with the warm LEDs. We have four of these. We got two over here and we have two over here. And we're also going to do some other cutting of cables, and I'll explain that as soon as the warm LEDs are in. And I have changed all the LEDs now for warm LEDs. So let me show you what they look like now. I did my best to make them as neat as possible. I think I succeeded in that. Let me turn on the... So they're now warm white LEDs. The LEDs are in both here and there. And for this cable, you go along these pins. These are screwed in. The instructions suggest going above this line over here. I decided to go down there because I saw it on certain websites where they did it underneath and it's less visible when it's going underneath. We'll have to find out. While screwing in these pins, you're also screwing in these metal, I'm not quite sure what these are. Pins? I'm not quite sure. They are probably going to go in later in the build, but for now they are just doing this. And of course I have these cables over here. These are for the strobes, but we'll have to figure out a way to get those as invisible as possible. Maybe actually going to paint these cables black. I don't know. Talking about black, I used the thick black paint to paint the rear side of the LEDs so we have no light leaks. And let me turn it around. Let me turn on the switch. Let's see how they look now. Well, they'll look yellow, but of course that's on camera. They are not yellow in real life. They are warm white. But as I said, they look yellow on camera. So here we have the Ecto-1 back again. I've cut off the center of the lights. I've reconnected these using this plug, as you can see. And the other side of the plug goes to that switch which I've installed on the floor, in exactly the same place where in the original Ecto-1 there is a foot pedal. So if you now touch that foot pedal, then the center lights will go on. This is, as far as I know, exactly the same method, or essentially the same way it works in the original Cadillac. So a foot pedal over here, let me see if I can reach it, which I've installed. And you switch off the center lights or the high beams. So the reason I've used a plug, by the way, is so I can still remove this entire thing from the build if necessary. So hold on, let me disconnect it for now. Okay, because what's going to happen, of course, is that this cable will also go underneath over here, so it will emerge somewhere around here in the engine compartment. So I bought myself this. Well, you can't see what it is now because I have encased it in a metal shiny box, which is an imitation of the so-called Wieland box. That is actually going to be glued on over here on the side of the car, which is exactly the same place where in the original Ecto-1 the Wieland box is installed. What is the Wieland box? Well, that is the actual box moved, placed by the movie studio to have the lights blinking in front of the headlights. So I imitated that box somehow by installing an actual mini circuit board inside, which has several cables running through it. First of all, this circuit board can run between 2 and 5 volts. So that's exactly what I need for this car. And you have several outputs with several blinking options. And what I've done is I have put some plugs in it. Now the purple plugs, they are the strobes, and the non-purple plugs are the flashers, which I will show you later. So I will glue that inside and then connect these plugs to the lights which I have installed. Allow me to show you. To the lights which I've installed earlier. So we have lights going in over here in the indicators. And we have, of course, the strobes. So when everything is connected and all the plugs are connected, we can see what will happen. So, well, once again, let me show you, let me give you the email address, so the internet link to which I found this particular item. As I said, it will be hidden in the engine compartment over here, glued on the side over here, and this cable will go down to one of these spare plugs, which are from the power mod, and these will be hidden somewhere to connect to the headlights. And here we have everything switched on. Well, almost everything. We got the blinking indicators down there. We got the strobes, and let's for fun turn on the headlights. That means we have to find the right button. There we go. So now we have the primary headlights on. But let's turn on the high beams, which is the foot pedal over there. There we are. And here we have also the high beams on. So with everything connected, everything is ready, we can disconnect all these plugs, because we're going to be removing this from the build for now. We're going to work on the frame of the car. Okay, after I've moved away the chassis of the car and the interior and the front section, let's go to stage 68, which is the body front frame, which is actually the frame that goes around the engine compartment. I've got the parts over here, they're metal, or most of them are metal. We got this frame over here, and we're going to add a few things to it. And in later stages, we're going to add the hood compartment onto it. Now, this section of the frame, including the interior of the hood, are going to be visible after the car is finished when you open up the hood. So that means that this section is going to be modified by me using, weathering. So let's first screw a few things together and then see what particular point I'm going to start modifying this weathering this part. Many of you have seen me do this technique before. It's the so-called salt technique. What you actually do is you spray paint dirt and grime and rust spots all over the metal piece, whatever piece you want to weather. Let it dry, then add some protective coat. In this case, I'm using a Pledge, so the undercoat is protected. Then you water the entire thing and sprinkle on, in this case, coarse sea salt. Maybe I'll do a little bit less coarse, maybe a bit finer grain. But you sprinkle that on. And what I then usually do, I wet the entire portion with the sea salt so it adheres to the metal, the frame. And when that's dry, I'm going to spray paint over it the original frame color, which in this case, of course, will be semi-gloss black. And then the magic would appear afterwards. But this is halfway during this process. So we're now waiting for all this water to dry, and then maybe I add a few little bit spots of finer sea salt before I start spray painting it with a semi-gloss black. With the main work done, I've done some additional work on it. It's not 100% what I had in mind, but it's coming close to it, actually, what I wanted to do. I made sure that this part is still very visible, so I used a cotton swab and cleaned up every layer of weathering, so you can still see it shining in a particular when the light hits it in a particular way. Anyway, talking about stage 69, we are going to connect this part to the aforementioned this part. We're going to use that using LM screws. So I made sure that all the last pieces of salt were gone from these holes, because it was still clogged in here. So what we need to do is just simply move it in position and then thrust it upwards. Oh, you can see it's already in, and it actually already stays into place. But we, of course, need to add some screws. So we got three LM screws over here, one on the side and one on the other side. Let's do that right now. Okay, we are in stage 70, and stage 70 is gonna, let me remove this thing first, because we don't need this for now. We're going to go in the rear section over here in stage 70, and we need to do a few things. We need to install this kick frame, which I have set aside, and this part, which is the latch for the rear door. And I had no idea where I left that, because I already opened the bags. So I looked around all my open containers. Where did I put it? Not here, not here. And then it hit me. I have here the box with all the screws. And sometimes I am smart, because in these boxes we get all the screws. So we got here, that's AM, BM, CM, Well, you know the drill. These are all the metal screws, and then we have this row, which is AP, BP, and so forth, the plastic screws. And what I did was, I ripped off the piece of cardboard which was connected to stage 70, because I took everything out, except of course the that latch. But I put this in one of these trays, and on top I found this part. So sometimes I'm smart, sometimes I'm not, but this time I'm smart. So this is the part for stage 70. Let me get the rear section of the car, because we're going to need it. Oh, let's see what kind of screws we need for that. Okay, I got the QP over here. And for that particular part, which I just show you, we need BM. So that is this box over here, which are the BM screws. Let me get the rear section of the car so we can install these two parts first. And then we're going to connect the entire thing onto the car using AM screws. But to avoid problems, I'm only taking out one of these boxes at a time. The kick frame is in, using three QP screws and a famous part. What part number is actually? 70C is in as well. Now we need to connect the back section of the car to... Well, this is going to be difficult on camera, but hold on. No, I'm kidding. It's heavy, not that heavy. Anyway, to the back section. Oh, we can't see it on screen. Hold on. it's too big. Anyway, this connects nicely together. However, this sits higher than the back section, as you can see. So we need to maybe turn it around on its roof. So we can get a good connection. We need to turn it upside down, I believe, anyway, to better reach the screws, which are going to be on the side. So I'm going to screw it in using the HM screws, and I'll get back to you as soon as they're in. Okay, here we are. Well, the entire car is now connected. Well, the entire frame is now connected. I can't hardly put it on the frame of the video, but you can see it over here. So, yeah, quick word of warning, though. You need HM screws for that, which of course are metal screws, so we need the oil, that's for certain. But you can see there are four holes along over here, and in two over here, two over there. In both cases you need the lower part of the hole, so the lower hole of the two. So the one over here, let me see if I can point it out with a screwdriver, the one over here and the one over here. Don't make the mistake that I did. I first had it over here, and then I felt the screw emerging on the other side. I thought, hey, that can't be correct. So yeah, you need the lower hole of both of these screw holes. And of course, the same on the other side. That will conclude the last construction for issue, I think, 18. Let me check if I'm correct. Is this 18? No, this was issue 19. What did we do this video? Issue 67, we did the other video, but we went on 68, 69, and stage 70. And of course, we took care of the electronics for the headlights, if I can find them over here. We changed the light bulbs of the headlights, and we added a lot more of cables and plugs over here for the effects, and hopefully I will get all these plugs nice out of the way. So that will conclude issue 19. Next week, no, not next week, but next video, we'll be working on the interior and the hinges for the hood. The hood itself was in stage 1, in issue 1, so I need to get that. Thank you so much for joining with me. If you have any questions about this build or anything else I'm building, don't hesitate to put a comment behind on the comment section of this video. It also helps with YouTube's algorithm, so that always helps. And hope to see each other in another 2 weeks for the next installment of the Ecto 1. Don't forget, we have of course the DeLorean 2, which will be next week. And who knows what we'll do after that. But anyway, thank you so much, and I hope to see you pretty soon for the next installment. Bye-bye.
B&T, custom-made models and dioramas. Ha! Like you click and subscribe you must.